Our next psalm is Psalm number 32 of Basu Nayak. Mrs. Seema Agarwal is the owner of two houses, the particulars of which are given below. Calculate her income from house properties for the assessment year 2021-22. I have already told you about the assessment year. Assessment year for your HS year is 2021-22 and previous year is 2020-21. That is the income year. In previous question, the question is given according to previous year. In this question, question is given according to assessment year. So you have to always remember that your previous year for this year is 2020-21 and assessment year is 2021-22. Now she has two house. First house let out for residence and second house let out for business. Now here is not mentioned that where the house is situated, so no question of net municipal value or gross municipal value is arise here. Municipal value is given here. Both the house are let out. First house is let out for residence and the second house is let out for business. Now municipal value for the both houses is given. Rent received is given. Rent received means the amount received as a rent. This is not annual rent. Remember that. Rent received means amount received for the house let out. Standard rent is given. No fair rent is here. Fire insurance, repair, ground rent, these you have to ignore because these expenses are not allowable as deduction. Again, I am telling you that you have only three expenses is allowed as deduction. One is municipal tax, another is standard deduction, and another is interest on loan for construction or purchase of house. So fire insurance, repair and ground rent, you have to ignore these three. Interest on loan for construction of the house is given here 10,500 and 7,000. Municipal tax paid. Tax is paid for the first house. Rate is 12%. You know 12% on municipal value you have to calculate. Paid by the owner. So this is allowed as deduction. And for the second house 10% paid by the tenant. And municipal tax paid by tenant is not allowable as deduction. Vacancy period 2 months for the first house. That means here rent received is 50,000. This is for actually 10 months. Because vacancy period when there is no tenant, in that time no rent is received. So this rent is for 10 months. But when we calculate gross annual value, we have to convert it in annual rent for 12 months rent. You have to remember this. Vacancy period is given and for the second house there is no vacancy period. Now we will do this sum. Sum number 32. First you have to write this heading. Computation of income from house property of Mrs. Seema Agarwal, a resident individual for the assessment year 2021-22. Relating to the previous year 2020-21. This is your heading. Okay. Now there is more than one house. So you have to draw three amount column. Rupees, rupees, rupees. This is mandatory. First house. What is the nature of occupancy you have to write here? That is let out for residence. Now for the first house. First you have to calculate gross annual value. And for the gross annual value, there are three steps. Step 1, municipal value 70,000 and there is a standard rent of 65,000. In case of step 2, there is no fair rent. So, municipal value will be your reasonable expected rent. If it exceeds standard rent, in that case standard rent is your reasonable expected rent. So, here reasonable expected rent, I have written here cannot exceed standard rent. So, standard rent is your reasonable expected rent because municipal value exceeds standard rent. Annual rent. here is a working note. I have told you in the question it is given rent received and there is a vacancy period of 2 months. That means that is a 10 months rent. Now here is the workings for the first house annual rent. Now 50,000 rent received is for 10 months. You have to convert it for 12 months. So how much will be the rent of 12 months? So multiplied by 12, by 50,000 divided by 10, you will get 1 month's rent, and that is multiplied by 12, that this is 60,000. This is the amount of annual rent. Now annual rent is 60,000. Step 3, hire of step 2. Now what is say a hire of step 2? Here is reasonable expected rent 65,000 and annual rent 60,000. Hire of these two is 65,000. From here you have to deduct loss due to vacancy if there is any vacancy period. In this question there is a vacancy period of 2 months, so you have to calculate loss due to vacancy. Here is the working note. First house loss due to vacancy, 50,000 divided by 10, you will get 1 month's rent multiplied by 2 because vacancy period is 2 months. So 10,000 is your loss due to vacancy. Now you have to deduct it from the hire of step 2. Loss due to vacancy is 10,000. I have written here working note 2. So gross annual value will be 55,000. From here you have to deduct municipal tax. Calculation of municipal tax is in working note 3. Here it is a working note. First house municipal tax. Municipal value was 70,000 and 12% is rate of municipal tax. So you have to compute municipal tax on municipal value. 12% of 70,000, that is 8,400. This is the amount of municipal tax, and municipal tax is paid by the owner given in the question. So after deducting municipal tax, you will get 46,600. This is your net annual value. You have to write it. Here it is net annual value. Okay. Now, from net annual value, there is only two allowable deduction. Deduction under section 24. Number A is standard deduction at the rate of 30% on NAV. NAV here 46,600. 30% of 46,600 is 13,980. And there is another point, that is interest on loan. Interest on loan is 10,500. So these two are allowable deduction. So total deduction is summation of those two deduction. So total amount of deduction is 24,480, and from the net annual value you have to deduct this 24,480. You will get 22,120. This is the income from the first house. Now come to the second house. Second house let out for business. Nature of occupancy is let out for business. In case of step 1, municipal value is given 45,000, but there is no standard rent. So in step 2, reasonable expected rent is municipal value itself, that is 45,000. Annual rent, here also it is given rent received. Rent received is 60,000, but there is no vacancy period. So what is rent received? That is actually annual rent. So annual rent is 60,000. So gross annual value is 60,000, higher of step 2. Now I have changed this paper, so you have to write here income from first house and gross annual value of house 2, that is 60,000. Municipal tax. Deduction for municipal tax, here I have written nil. Why nil? Working note 4. Go to the working note. Second house municipal tax paid by the tenant. Municipal tax paid by the tenant. So no deduction is allowed for that. That's why here municipal tax amount is nil. So net annual value is 60,000. That means ग्रॉस एनुअल वैल्यू एंड नेट एनुअल वैल्यू इज इक्वल इफ म्यूनिसिपल टैक्स इज नील. फ्रॉम हियर देयर इज टू डिडक्शन, डिडक्शन अंडर सेक्शन 24. नंबर ए स्टैंडर्ड डिडक्शन एट द रेट ऑफ 30% ऑन NAV 60,000, 30% of 60,000, that is 18,000, and interest on loan is 7,000. So total amount of deduction is summation of these two deduction, that is 25,000, and deducting from net annual value, income from the second house is 35,000. Now, first house there is an income 22,120, and second house there is an income 35,000. So total income from house property of Mrs. Seema Agarwal is addition of these two income, that is 57,120.